si tu veux aborder des portes de lecteur dans le système sur 1963. Ok. D'ici tu divides une 10 parts. The first part is the schematic power trend. Okay. The second is I'm going to show some video that I downloaded online about the servo valve. Okay, after I give you some element. Okay, now we are going to start to learn about the servo position you have in this machine. For example, the neutral position for wall travel, reverse travel, left and right turn, in the pivot turn, and the counter at the turn. Okay, now we are going to explain this. In this schematic, I explain only the portrait. Okay, I don't explain about the equipment and another thing. Okay. What you have to know about the portrait? The portrait don't concern everything. The portrait concern only this section, this element, this another element, and this. Okay. Okay. Notice this element. I'm going to take a look to each element. For example, here you have the leaf motor. This is the leaf motor. You see, motor group. That means in this motor you have several elements. You have many elements. For example, this actuator piston, the motor, this switching valve, and this hot valve. Okay, or you can call cooling valve. Now you have this control valve. Okay, the second part of this video I'm going to show how many components you have in the servo valve and how can you make easily repair to the servo valve. Here you have the main line, and you have this pilot line. This pilot line help to release this brake, because here you have the brake and piston. Here you have your spring. You know that when the engine is stopped, when it is stopped, you have this brake who have to hold or to retain the machine. Okay. If okay, now you can go in this another side. Okay, you use this line, and this line help you to learn more about the circuit. Okay, you have the same line here. Okay, inside you have the two pump. Here you have your engine, here you have the front pump and rear pump. Okay. The front pump may be drive the right motor, and the rear pump drive the lift motor. Okay, inside this you have these two valves. The same time, this valve is like the makeup valve, okay? Because this valve can protect the board line when you have when you have a lack of oil, when you don't have the good flow of oil in the line. This valve help you to protect the circuit. And here you have the charge relay valve. Here you have your actuator piston. That actuator piston give the great angle, give the great angle to the wash plate. Here you have another servo valve, okay? This servo valve have two solenoid. It's simple, but in this video I'm going to give you many things about. Here you have the same thing. This is another pump. You have the rear pump who supply oil to the leaf motor. You have the same valve, and here you have the charge valve. Okay, this is the charge pump. This is the charge pump. The charge pump, you have here a filter and bypass switch. This bypass switch, this pump have the same thing. The same thing, you can see that here you have the same thing. You have the charge filter and bypass switch. Here you have the cutoff transmission and the brake. Okay, this is solenoid brake and this solenoid transmission. Okay, this transmission help when you are in the neutral position. Here you have the bypass valve to the cooler. Okay, when the cooler is not good function, when the cooler does not function good, this bypass help oil to return to in the tank. Okay, after all that, I'm going to show you another thing. Here you have the equipment or implement pump, implement pump. Here you have the fan pump. This is small secret about the motor pump. This is the right motor. Okay, this is the right motor. In the right motor you have this the same thing out relay valve. You have the flushing valve, and here you have the check valve, actuator, piston, but now you can call the shift actuator, piston, and servo valve. Okay, after show you all that thing, you are going now to talk about the servo valve in the second part. I download this video because it's more useful for you. In this video I'm going to show you the main component to the servo valve. Okay, after this you have one great idea about what you are going to learn about what this valve operate. About how this valve will operate, because sometimes you can see the schematic, you try to understood what you see, but it's impossible because you don't know more about the component. If you misunderstood about this valve, you doesn't hear this video very good. Okay. Here you have some person who disassembled this. Okay, now he removed the nut coil. In this moment he has been removed the nut coil, the seal, the second seal, and here here you go to start to remove this tube assembly. In this tube assembly you have two things. You have the spring and you have this push rod. Okay, is this push rod when you send the signal here to move and push the spool. In the another side you have the same thing, nut coil, seal, Koi and body. Okay. Here is what you call the tube assembly. This is the tube assembly. Inside the tube assembly, you have many things, but the main thing is the spring and push rod. Okay. You don't control that because if you don't have this spring, it's not good for the system. Okay. You have to push very freely. When you push the spool have to move free. Okay. It does have any it's not good to have any scratch inside or any damage. Okay. You have to push your spool like that. When you remove your spool, you have to control the position because this indicate the correct position of this spool. Okay. Now you have to control every thing about this spool of this control valve. Here you have the model of you have the serial number, you have the schematic how this operate. After you control every scratch, every damage, you control the seal if the seal is or is still good. If the seal is still good, after you try to remove to put the spool. Okay, here you have to control every scratch or damage because if you have some problem in this spool, it's not this spool does not move correctly. After you put your washer in the both part, this washer help to retain the spring. Okay, because if you forget to put this the system does not work very good. Yeah, you control all that same thing. Okay. Now you control the damage of your coil. Okay. After you put the coil in the tube assembly, don't forget to put your seal O-ring. After you tighten with this nut coil. Okay. Okay, when you tighten all that thing, you have to put the grip torque because all that thing have the grip torque. If you put more, you can destroy, but if you put less, you can create the leakage. If you have the leakage, the system cannot operate good. Okay, here you can tighten your nut. You have to control all that connector. Okay, in this third part, I'm going to show you some component, some element. Here you have the motor pump. Here you have your transmission lever. Here you have the electronic control module. This is servo valve that you are already see. Here you have this servo valve, how he operates when he receives the signal is this Y that manages the coil and the push rod, the plus and push the spool. Okay, it's the same thing in this side. Okay, inside you have only the hole, you have the supply pump hole, you have the line A and line B. This is the tank. Okay. For example, here you have the tank, and here the oil go to the tank. It's all about the component. Okay, now we are going to the to the fourth part in this online lesson. Okay, in this part, don't worry about all that component, because it's easy to define the name. Okay, if you worry about all that thing, it's not good to you. It's not good to you if you want to improve your skill in algorithm. You are going to give the name of all that complement. First, you have this speed sensor. You have this piston, this spring. You have the brake. Here is this servo valve. Here you have the implement rotor. Here you have the pilot rotor. Here you have the crankcase rotor. Okay, this the line. You have the motor. Okay, this the outlet of the motor. Here you have the pump fan. Here you have the equipment pump or implement pump. Inside you have this PCH5, this leaf motor, the check valve, another check valve. Here you have the chief actuator piston. Here you have another speed sensor, piston, spring. Here you have another brake, leaf motor. You have the servo valve here, another line. Here you have the line. This the filter and bypass switch. Here you have the test port. You have another filter and bypass switch. This the PCH, another PCH, test port. All this three is the test port. Here you have the rear pump, the rear piston pump, and here you have the front piston pump. This is the line. This is the test port. Here you have a line, the engine, another line, test port, cooler, oui, cooler. You have the check valve, you have the transmission, here you have the transmission solenoid, and here you have the brake solenoid. Okay, this is another test port. Here you have the crankcase rotor. Okay, this is the rotor manifold, the servo valve, another test port. This another servo valve. You have its PCH. Okay. After this, you have to know that here you are in the neutral position, and when you are in the neutral position, it's too simple. You interpret the two signal that control lever of transmission send. Okay. After you interpret this, if you promote, you determine that you have the neutral position. Okay, that means the lever is in the middle. Okay, no down or up, no forward or reverse. Okay, and this moment when the lever is neutral, it's same as any signal to the pump, to this pump or this two motor. Okay, when the same send the signal, for example, the signal arrive in the control valve. Okay, in what side of this you have this control valve. Okay, at this moment you don't have enough of operation, you don't have anything, because when you have no signal to the solenoid of piston and motor, when you have no signal to the piston motor, this take the pump, the motor, okay, in the motor in the maximum displacement. Okay, as a result, no signal to the solenoid of piston pump, the pilot line in line 36 flow through the servo valve 17. Okay, in the same time, this line of flow to the servo valve 18. Okay, but now the oil go through these two pieces, but in this moment, in each side of the actuator piston, you have the same pressure. Okay, it's not possible that one pressure overcome and the spring. Okay, it's not easy that one pressure overcome the spring inside this actuator valve. Okay, at this moment, what will happen in this servo valve? You don't have any signal in the both part of servo valve, and this time the servo rest in this position. Okay, when the oil come to from this line 36, the oil go to the actuator piston through this servo valve, and this oil return in the gas grain by this 33 passage. Okay, in the same thing inside this pump, when you doesn't have any signal in the both part of the servo valve, oil come inside, go to the actuator. Since the pressure is equal in the both part, it doesn't have any movement because all the force is equal. After the oil turn in the crankcase with the 38 line, the 8 passage. Now you are in the forward travel position. In forward travel position, it doesn't have many components. I'm going to give you only the components that this system use when you want to be in the forward position. Okay, in forward position, what will happen? First, you have only in the right motor, you have your servo valve and the speed sensor for the speed sensor. In the left motor, you have the same thing, servo valve and speed sensor. Okay, but now inside the schematic, you have this pilot line 36, okay, 36, and this ground line 38 servo valve. Here you have the actuator piston. Here you have the passage 35. Here you have this line and this line. Okay. You have this passage and this servo valve 17, and you have this crankcase. Okay. But after show you all this, I want that you try to learn this circuit by yourself. Okay. What mean what? First, you have to know the meaning of all that color. For example, red color, red and blank base color. What does she mean? Okay. You have the green color, yellow color. First, you have to know that the red color is about the high pressure. The red and blank space red is that pressure is high but smaller than the red color. Okay, this pressure show that you have the right. But now when you have the yellow color, if you know the pump or motor, that means that in this moment that element take this position, or in this moment if you put some gauge in the test port, you can receive the pressure. Okay, but every time the test port is in yellow. But now you have, for example, this engine. When you see this engine is yellow, that means what? The engine turn in this moment, and this time you have this charge relief valve pressure. What does it mean? That means in this moment, this circuit can send enough or small oil in the tank when the pressure overcome. Okay, when you have the pressure more than one the specific one prevent, one the specification prevent. Okay. All that valve will show you the position that you have right now inside this valve when you're in the forward position. Okay. You have the same thing, the SCM or electronic control module, who take the information about the position of the lever. Okay. And after they take this position, because you receive the signal every time you push or you pull the lever. Okay. And about the disposition, the ECM determine if you are forward, neutral, and reverse position. After this, it send the position. But in this time, you are in the forward position. Okay, in this moment, what happened? The SM send a signal to the motor 9 and 27. Okay, put this valve 7. Okay, and this valve 32. Okay, in the same moment, the SM send the signal to servo valve 18, okay, this servo valve to the pump 14 and 17 to the pump 11. Okay, but after this, what happened? When the ECM send the signal, That mean what? That mean you are in this position or this. But if you want to be forward, you have to stand in the right side of this valve and the left side of this. When I tell the right side, it's not about the component or the real operation. It's about the schematic we have. I don't know that. I don't want that when you are in the machine, you choose right and leave about what I'm saying now. Okay, you have to think about your problem, not about the position that I give in this video. So what I'm going to say, the variation of the signal is about the position of control level. Okay, the signal to the forward solenoid unit of the piston pump vary about the what the receive is the same thing of the front pump. Okay, but now as the result, okay, when you are in the piston pump, for example, 17 pilot oil, okay, look to this valve and the same time in this valve and come here inside this actuator piston. When the oil come inside this, the oil overcome the force of this spring. Okay, the oil overcome the force of this spring. You know that this spring is opposite to this other spring. Okay, and the actuator shift in this position. When actuator shift in this position, the oil from the chamber actuator piston go in this passage and return in the crankcase. At the same moment, you have the same thing here. Oil come from this pilot line, arrive in the actuator piston through this servo valve. After the oil overcome the force of this spring and the what we take this position. After the oil inside this chamber go through the servo valve and return in the cast grain. Now, after you have this operation, I list inside this front pump. What happened? The oil go through this line, through this line, through this line, this line. The pump, the motor, okay, and supply the motor. The motor start to turn after the oil go through this line, pass like that, and return in the circuit. But in the other part of this video, I'm going to explain you. Okay, in the same moment, you have this. Other pump, this other piston pump, same oil like this. This passage, the oil go like that to this line and arrive here, okay, and turn the motor. In this position, how can you call other line? This is forward line. Here you have your reverse line. Okay, inside this motor you have the flushing valve. The flushing valve help to send oil in the cooler. Okay, in this schematic it's not easy to show all that thing. But another schematic, this flushing line help oil to go to the cooler before oil go to the to the tank. Why I explained that because somebody saw that this is the tank, but it's not the real tank, okay? This is the cast grain. The cast grain is the housing of the element. For example, here you have the motor. The cast grain is the housing of the motor who receives the oil, okay? After this, the oil go through the circuit and arrive in the cooler. Because if you don't cooling, if you don't cool the oil, it's not good enough to the circuit. You have to know that the sensor speed is monitoring by the ECM. Okay. It's the same thing to the engine speed. Okay. If you have the reason that you have the ECM inside the circuit is because the ECM have to adjust the signal, okay, in order to prevent underspeed or overspeed. You know the underspeed condition is the same thing to the stall condition, okay? Here you are in the reverse position, okay? But I'm going to try to explain you about this, but in my humble opinion, you have to be capable to explain in this step, okay? Why I told that? Because if you know more about the color, about the component, you can explain. For example, when I told that you are in the reverse position, you remark that or you observe that you have this line in red and this other line in red. What does it mean? That means here you have the reverse line, and here you have another reverse line. In this moment, the pump send oil inside these two line because you want that the motor turn in the reverse direction. Okay, inside the pump, you have the same thing. Okay, inside the pump, you have the same thing. The electronic control module receive the signal. Okay, the signal is about the level. Okay, if the level don't move, the ECM receive any signal, and the ECM does not move the servo valve. Okay. But this thing will determine that the lever in the reverse position. If you push the lever to the reverse position about the signal, the ECM can determine the position. Okay. At this moment, the ECM will send the signal to the piston, pump, and motor. But now I'm going to start again. To the rear, piston pump. Okay, this is supply or this pilot line send pressure inside this control valve. But in this time, the control valve is in this position. Okay, when the control valve is in this position, that means that the oil go through this line. After the oil arrive inside this actuator piston, and this oil overcome the opposite force spring, when this overcome, this push the wash plate in this position, and wash plate can send oil in this line. Okay, but in this moment, what happened? In the right side of the actuator valve, the oil go through the servo valve and arrive in Kes Green. In this moment, when the oil arrive in the Kes Green, the pressure go through this line. Okay, this line. The oil go through this line. Okay, this is 40 line. Okay, and arrive here through this reverse line and turn the motor in reverse direction. Okay, in the same moment the signal arrive here. Okay. Okay, when the signal arrive here, this actuator or shift actuator piston help or in this side or in the head end of this cylinder to go through the, this valve to the gas crank. Okay, this same moment oil can return in this line. Okay, oil can return in this line before he arrive in this aspiration line of the pump. In the same moment you have the same thing here, oil arrive in this control valve, but before this the oil the control valve take this position because you receive the signal here, and oil go to the valve and arrive to this actuator. After this actuator push watch pay in this side because this pressure go over this spring. Okay, after the oil return to the cauldron with this passage, at the same moment the pump send oil through this line, and oil arrive in the motor piston. Okay, after when this valve is supplied with the signal, the oil in the head end to this actuator go to the tank. Okay, after this you have the same thing. Okay, now I'm going to explain this. This is what I'm called the makeup valve and relay valve. Okay, you have the same in one component. First, when the charge circuit is sent oil here, what happened? You know that only in the neutral position this the pressure in this circuit is the same pressure in this circuit, in this line. Okay, the pressure in this line is the same pressure in this line because you have only the pressure of the charge circuit, because in this moment you have the wash plate in zero angle. Okay, when the wash plate is in the zero angle, it doesn't have anything, but in this moment the relay valve doesn't work, it's only the check valve who work. Okay, but now when you give the angle of this wash plate pump piston, what happened? You have one circuit in the high pressure. When the pressure go over the highest pressure, this valve open the circuit and send oil in this circuit. Okay, the same oil return in other line and help the circuit to have enough of oil. Okay, what happened? I'm going to repeat. The ECM here protect the circuit and help to have the quick performance in this circuit. Okay, because the ECM or electronic control module set the speed through the engine motor and the spit through the port motor. Okay. The SM set the speed to the engine motor and the piston motor. Okay. The SM adjusts all the signal to prevent the same thing I told you on the speed or stall condition and over speed. Okay. And the SM ensure that the two motor tracking in the script, okay, because if you the two cannot track in the script, it's not possible that you go in the straight line. Okay. Okay, now you are in the lifting position. You have two kind of turn. You have the pivot and control turn. Okay, you have to know what is the team mean, what all that mean. Okay, but I told you something. You have to determine how the circuit function. Even you have only the color. Okay, you don't want to know about the component, about all that thing, but the color can show you the mean, even it's little, it's not bad. But now I'm going to give you some idea that can help you to read any schematic you have. Okay, we are going to start. For example, here you have the pilot pressure. Okay, this is the orange pilot pressure. Orange means that this pressure has the same pressure to the pilot circuit. Okay, it's not the problem about this can turn or not turn the pump. Okay, the first problem is you have to be capable to see that or to remain how is the meaning of any color. Okay, I don't explain you everything now. When you see that you have this color inside, okay, at the same moment here you have the red line. And here you have a blank with the red line. Okay, what does it mean? Does it that mean that here you have the high pressure and here you have another pressure? It's dangerous, but it's not dangerous that the highest pressure. Now I'm going to explain you the circuit. First, you have the same thing I give you. The same name and the same function. When you check the Google, you can notice that the rear pump does work in the real circumstance. Here you have only the pilot pressure. Okay, what does it mean? At this moment, the ECM send only the signal in the front pump. Okay, because when you doesn't have any signal in this control valve, it's not possible that the pump will take another position. I'm going to explain all this. Okay, I repeat the same thing. The ECM receive the signal about the position of the lever and determine the position of the circuit. Okay, because here you are in the forward position. You are in the forward position. Okay, what the ECM going to do first? The same send any signal in this comprovable 18, and it's the same thing here. Okay, it's not the same thing here, please. The SM here send the signal in this part of this servo valve, and the oil go to the actual top piston through this valve. After this pressure overcome the opposite spring, and in this site the oil go through this servo valve again and arrive in the gas gland through the SS 33. At this moment, the wash plate go in this side and the pump start to flow in this direction. When the pump flow in this direction, the pressure go like this and arrive inside the piston motor. At the same moment, all go like this and do that this motor turn. When the motor turn, here you don't have the same thing because inside you have only the charge pressure, and the pressure arrive here and go through the both way in this motor. Okay, in this moment you doesn't have enough of pressure who can do that the motor turn forward or reverse. This pressure help only you can move the leaf motor. But here this is not is different, okay, because here you have the high pressure. The high pressure do that the motor turn in the forward direction. If this turn, I'm going to ask you some question. If this turn in this in forward direction, for example, like that, and this doesn't turn, okay, any direction, what happened? If you consider that here you have a machine, okay, the thing is the machine go like that. Okay, the machine go like that. Okay, if the machine go like that, you have the leaf turn. Okay, here you have the leaf turn. If the machine go like that, you have the leaf turn. You can remember that even you do a mistake about your reading, if you do your analysis like this, if you organize your thought like this, it's not easy that you check or you be trouble about what you are going to explain somebody. Okay, in the same moment I'm going to tell you the ECM help you to perform your circuit. You don't have over speed or under speed condition. Okay, this is that kind of term who help you to do more fast. Okay, to turn more fast and you to turn in the biggest angle. Okay, because when you have the pivot turn, the machine turn only about the crack. Okay, the machine turn or rotate through the crack side to the leaf crack side. Okay, but here the machine or the engine rotate through the center axis. Okay, what I call the center axis, the center axis is the medium of the machine. What I call the cracked, the leaf cracked. The leaf cracked is this part of the cracked. Okay, this is only the schematic. I want to show you that you have the vision, like you are face to the machine. Okay, that does not mean inside the schematic you have the leaf tract. Okay, but now when I told that we have or you are in the left hand counter rotate, what does it mean? This means you have to move this motor if you want to do that. And the schematic can you give you more about that? Here you have the red line. Okay, here you have the red line and its reverse line, and here you have another red line is forward. Okay, at this moment what happened? If here you have forward and here you have the reverse line that is supply, you have to turn in the left side. When you want to turn, you have to use the pressure of the board pump. You have to move this controller, this 70 controller, in this position, because in this position you have the oil hook come inside the piston actuator. Okay, and this pressure overcome the opposite spring, and this spring return in the crankcase through this valve. At the same moment, pressure go in this circuit. Okay, pressure go in this line, in this line, and arrive inside the motor. Okay, inside the motor. The same moment pressure go like this, okay, and return to the front pump. Okay, the same moment the ECM send a signal in this side of control valve, and oil go like that, arrive in this actuator piston and overcome the opposite spring, oil back to the crankcase. In this moment, this pump produce a flow in this line. When the pressure increase, the pressure make that the leaf motor pump turn and oil back to this rear pump through the line, this line. Okay, this line doesn't have the name for this line. After this is easy to you, but in other video I forgot to tell you that before this crack turn or this crack turn, what happens? You have this line who supply the brake. After he release the brake, because inside you have the piston push the spring or overcome the force of spring and release this brake. At the same moment you have the same thing here. Okay, you have the same thing here. When this turn in the reverse and this forward, you have the counter rotate turn. Okay, this is easy. Okay, the same moment I told you that the into rotate through the center's axis to the machine, the ECM do the same job. Okay, the ECM do the same job. The nine part of this video, the machine turn in the right side. Okay, what happened? It's the same thing. Okay, if the machine turn in the right side, restaurant vont répondre au Center of Supply des circuits, des right circuits. For example, or the left circuit. But in this moment, if you want to go in the right side, you have to supply the left electronic control module. Send the signal in this control valve. After the oil can go through this line, arrive in this actuator piston and overcome the opposite force spring. After in this line, the oil return in the crankcase through the valve and this passage 38. After this, the pressure push this piston and the pump will go in this the wash plate go in this side. Okay, the pressure in this phone pump is only the charge pressure. Okay, and the pressure go like that, arrive inside the right motor and go through the right motor and return to the front pump. Okay, at this moment this motor does not turn in the forward or reverse, but it can turn if you push enough of pressure. Okay, at the same moment, what happened here? The pressure arrive in the motor, okay, and this pressure turn the motor in the forward direction. But here you don't have any motion forward or reverse. If you don't have anything here, if you don't have anything here, what happens? The engine go like that. If engine go like that, you are in the right turn. Okay. In this moment, the engine will return in right track or pivot in right track. Okay. At the same moment, the SM monitor the both signal of speed and signal of sensor and prevent many mistakes, for example, overspeed, understeed, and control that the servo valve work properly. Here you have this line and you have this another line. This is the reverse and this is forward. Okay. After this, the oil return here. Okay, the oil return here and oil return here. Okay, you have the same as control valve who receive the signal. Okay, you have the same control valve who receive the signal. This valve is in this position and this other is in this position. Okay, this position and this position. Okay, in this moment, what happened? The pressure go through this pump and supply the leaf motor. Okay, but it's supplying the forward direction and this front pump do the same job. Okay, when oil arrive in this actuator piston through this valve, they all overcome the pressure inside this part of actuator and the pressure go to the crankcase. After the pump supply the lane in the supply the reverse line of this motor and the motor start to return in reverse. If the motor to turn in reverse, the engine rotate about the center axis, okay? And this moment, engine go more fast when you have the motor who turn in the different direction, okay? And this moment, the SM is a great thing about the circuit because the SM perform everything, okay? The SM perform everything inside this circuit, okay? If you want to join my online class, it's good to write, to send email and other thing. It's so free, all that thing.